Hi guys, John Turner here again. So we're going to look at a little problem that we have here with the TV. So you might have an older style TV and you want to broadcast to your Bluetooth headphones, and your TV probably doesn't have Bluetooth, as this one doesn't and a lot don't. So you've got a bit of an issue on your hands. There's lots of Bluetooth adapters out there. It's a bit of trying to find out what will work, and a bit of trial and error. So I thought I might make a quick video and just help you out on making some choices. So on the back of typically on the back of these TVs, you'll have some sort of optical out or coax out, which is your digital signal, and you have some analog channels as well. You'll have a headphone jack and some RCA ports, left and right channel. The issue is with the RCA ports that you'll have to switch to those to broadcast from your remote to that input, and if you use your headphone jack on the side, you'll have a mute situation where you'll have to plug the device in every time you want to use your headphones, and it might be an inconvenient position behind the TV that you can't get to. So using that headphone jack, that 3.5mm headphone jack to connect your Bluetooth adapter to, is going to cause you some issues, because you're going to have to unplug it every time you want to listen to TV or without the headphones on. So this could potentially be an issue that you might want to get around. So I've got a little solution. Of course, it's dependent on the TV you have and the outputs you do have. If you have an optical out, that's probably the best way to go, also called Toshlink. So what I've done, the first thing I've done is bought this little device here. It's called Avantree. It's the Oasis Plus long range wireless audio transceiver. Okay, this particular model can transceive and receive, but for your Bluetooth headphones, you want a transceive mode. So that's a little product that I've just purchased. Let's open it up. Never used one before. So what we have inside this box, I have to open it up. It's got a seal on it. You don't have to break. Okay, this is the unit. Alrighty. So it's, as you can see, it's quite a nice small unit. Nice and neat. So what inputs we have on the back of this one? We have an input and we have an output. This particular model has input and output. That's the plus of this particular model. So you can take optical in, or you can take the 3.5mm aux port in, and you can also push it out as well through the white connector. So there your input outputs, and also you have a charge, which is just a typical DC in there. So you'll have some cables in here. Let's have a look. So a bunch of cables, and a startup guide and warranty. $5 off your next order. Okay, we'll just put that aside. So this is the typical connector that you'll find. This is the 3.5mm jack. It's got, you can tell it's got the two channels with the two bands there. So that's typically what a lot of TVs have this available. So you plug that into your input there from the TV. It's actually marked. You can see it, TV input. and then this would go into your headphone jack on your TV. All right, and the problem, as soon as you do that, the volume's probably going to cut out on your TV, and while this device is plugged in, then you're not going to have any sound coming out of your TV. You'll get a Bluetooth to your headset, but you won't get a connection. You won't have any sound coming out until you unplug it. The issue is that those ports are in the side, they're hard to get at, so that's not really the way I want to go with this. The other option, you can go with these RCA. Alright, you'll have a left and right channel on the RCA ports on the back of the TV potentially, or your amplifier, you could use those, and then you plug that into the connector port, female port, and then again back into the back port. So that's another way to do it. With that method, you'll have to switch the inputs on your TV. It's not such a bad way to go. That's probably the third preference I'd go with, because at least that way you've got ability to switch without hopping into the back of the TV all the time. So that's but that is an analog connection, so that's not going to be the best connection you can make. Here's our number one choice. So this is your Tosh link. So if you've got an optical, connection on the back of your TV or your amplifier, then you plug this into the back of your unit there, and the other end into the back of your TV, and you've got an optical signal, digital signal, into your Bluetooth, which is good. And that signal is continuous, and so you won't have to unplug it. It can stay connected. You'll effectively have digital sound going into your Bluetooth, and then transmitted to your headphones. And at the same time, it will be also still coming out of your speakers. And that means you'll just have to hit the mute button, turn down the volume. That means you'll have to turn down the volume on your TV, and you should be okay, because that won't affect this audio signal coming out here. We don't have that luxury of having that connection, so we've still want to maintain that audio, that digital audio signal. So we've purchased this device, which is a bi-directional Tosh link to coax. The TV, a lot of TVs have coax connection on the back of them, which is that sort of connection, and that coax connection is a digital signal, much like your Tosh link. So we've bought this device, which is a converter from Avencore. Okay, so we'll have a look in here, see what we've got. Again, it's sealed. Open that up. Okay. Not much in there except the charge cable. Well, I think this particular one may or may not have a battery. We're going to keep it plugged in all the time. You don't get the power adapter, but you do get the charge cable for it. We'll just open this up. So the way this will work, there's your charge port. You keep that plugged in, you'll connect it to a transformer or power pack there to keep that 5 volt going into it. And then you have, that's your output, this is your input. So you'll have your coax coming from your TV, plug in there into the input. If of course you had this Tosh link or optical connection in the back of your TV, then you would use that, but I don't. So this is what the whole point of this little channel today is to show what you can do, potentially maintain your digital signal going in from the coax coming out of the back of your TV into your converter, and then you can use this Tosh link cable provided. Or you might need a longer one, this is pretty short. I'm just throwing in with the was thrown in with the Bluetooth device from Avencore, but it's a bit short, to be honest, to be, unless you're using that on your amplifier, it's only metre long, so it's not much use in my situation, but it's good for demonstration purposes. So you go to the Toshlink output. Okay. And we'll connect that in there, like that. And then this will go in the input and the back of your Bluetooth. So that's your Avantree Oasis Plus. So the first part of this puzzle, that'll go the coax in the back of your TV. The coax goes into the converter that we have here from Avencore. The converter still transmits from the coax to the Toshlink, maintains that digital signal into the back of your Bluetooth device, which will then give you the best audio you can have out from here. And so that will give you not only the best audio, but it'll also give you a feed into this device that you don't have to get into the back to plug your 3.5mm in to get that audio signal. So we've gone from an analog plug that's difficult to get to, and we've swapped it out for a digital signal going into our Bluetooth device from this converter using that coax cable. So that'll give you your best result. And just looking at this device, it has a few options here. And I'll just quickly go through them. I haven't used this device before, so when we plug it in, we might have a look at it then. But on the side, you have transmit, receive, the TX or transmit, which is the one we're going to use there. Receive that way, so you can send to the device, but in this case, we'll transmit from the device. It'll go out Bluetooth. And on the side, we have priority, HD priority, or LL priority. So that's so you want either latency as a priority or the sound as a priority, so the quality of the sound. So it depends on what your situation is. If you get a HD priority and not have a latency issue with limp sync issues, that's probably the way to go. But anyway, that's it. Pretty simple device. Again, we've got a power adapter in the back. Let's supply it again, and no transformer, so you'll have to supply that. You'll need two transformers, one for the Bluetooth device in this setup, and one for the converter. And that's it. We'll plug this in. We'll get the TV off the wall, get this cable in the wall, and then we'll have a look at it and see if it works. We're back to the TV. So we have our Bluetooth Avantree device here. We have it connected to our converter, our coax to Toshlink converter. So we have those two connected together. Now we have our power supply. So you're going to need a power supply. Neither one of these units came with a power supply, so you're going to need a power supply. And then obviously we're going to connect the power supply port. Your converter is going to need power to convert that to a fiber optic signal, and you're going to need a power supply connector here for our Bluetooth device, okay, so they're both plugged in together and powered, or not quite powered yet, but then we have our coax connection coming from the back of the TV itself. We'll plug that into the coax input. Okay, this unit's bi-directional, so it doesn't matter too much. And I think we're good to go, so I'll plug this in and we'll bring the camera in closer to have a look at. Okay, so we're all connected now. We've got the fibre optics in the back there. We've got the power on. We've got our converter here. We've got our power supply there, so we just power this on.
Power on. Bluetooth transmitter mode with active bypass. Pairing mode. Please put your device into pairing mode and wait.
That's pretty cool, right? So yeah, this unit actually talks. Has speech, so it helps you with the instructions. So at the moment, you see the flashing light, it's in transmit mode, the TX, and optical in, and it's in transmit mode at the moment, so it's trying to pair. So let's see if we can get a Bluetooth headphones to pair with it. So we have our Bluetooth headphones. We'll switch these on. Okay, these are in pairing mode.
Connected. Ready for use.
All right, so there you go. So if you notice, then I just put these straight into pairing mode, and we're able to get a connection, and your device here confirmed that connection. So our unit's powered off now. Powered on.
Power on. Bluetooth transmitter mode with active bypass.
Okay, we'll switch our headphones on. And
connected, ready for use.
You can see there, if you can get in close enough, there's a little A symbol popped up there, so that this is a Bluetooth 5 connection, so it has two channels, A and B. And if you notice there, that channel A just connected as an example. All right, we've got our two Bluetooth headphones there. We'll plug in our device.
Power on. Bluetooth transmitter mode with active bypass.
Okay, you'll see the channels are not connected. We'll switch on one of the headphones. Put it into pairing mode. The second device hasn't connected here, but as my son's pointed out to me, if you hold down the Bluetooth button,
pairing mode. Please put your device into pairing mode and wait.
And there you go.
Connected. Ready for use.
You have the two channels, A and B, both headphones are now connected. So we'll test it out now and see how well that works. We're back, we'll switch this TV on. Give it a moment to start. Okay, so as I said, that audio channel, the coax and the Tosh link, continually output. You don't have to switch to a particular audio channel or plug into the 3mm, 3.5mm headphone jack. But what you will have to do is turn the volume down or mute. And then hopefully, all being well,
these headphones are working now. And my son's going to come over and put the other ones on and test them.
Yep.
So there you go. Both headphones are working. They work in combination with the digital out, which is always on. You don't have to switch to that actual port, to that input, to actually get to the device, because it's continually fed there. But you do have to turn the volume down. As you can see, now you'll have, potentially you could have, you know, two people watching and listening on their headphones and another person sitting in the room. You could turn your volume up and they'd have the same audio. And as for latency, so the lip sync seems really good. There is a connection on the side for priority, for latency or definition. So you have that. If you have an issue, you can switch over to latency. That'll give you extra power. It'll basically put priority on that signal. So I'm also going to test the distance that we can go in this house with one of these headphones. So there we go, 20 meters. I was able to make to the letterbox and back before we lost our signal. I'm not too sure. Typically we get about 10 meters range out of Bluetooth before we start losing them, but this is a long range device. Typically we won't be using it for that, but you know, if you can't see the TV, I don't see the point. Unless you're listening to music, then it's going to be really important to you. But anyway, about 20 meters as far as I can tell, out to the front door, maybe 25 meters max before you start to lose that signal. Okay, that's it. Hopefully that was informative, and we'll catch you next time.